heard somebody teach you that somewhere. So how about that ice? Down out there now. It's a good thing you didn't have to get out in it, huh?
Yeah, I wish we didn't have to, but we had to go get some groceries.
You did you? Somebody told me they seen you coming out of that junior college on Saturday. I said, you got to be mistaken. My wife don't go to no college. My wife stays home.
I'm sorry. I'm so sorry.
You getting out of ice or what?
I was gonna tell you about it, but
ice, damn it! Get into his house. There's no telling after that. Right? You're gonna need some time to think about what you've done.
Are you okay?
Yeah. Yeah, it was just another bad dream. I'm okay. Let's go back to sleep, all right?
Are you sure?
Yeah.
You know, I'm meeting Mom for lunch today.
Oh, yeah?
Why don't you want to meet her?
Come on, Janice, what are you talking about? Of course I want to meet her, I'm super busy today.
No, I'm not just talking about today. Every time it comes up, you have an excuse. This is like the third or fourth time, Ray.
It's a coincidence. It means nothing. Why would I not want to meet your mother, for God's sakes?
I don't know. Why don't you tell me?
You're reading way too much into this, Janice.
You're reading too much into this. We are getting married, right? It's supposed to be part of it. Meet the parents.
Look. I have every intention of meeting your mother, all right? I gotta go, I'm late. Bye.
You can't keep putting this off, Ray. I don't know what you're so afraid of.
You know that I love you, right?
Right.
I'll meet your mom. Promise.
Ray.
Meet John Phillips on the phone, please.
Hey, just a minute.
Thank you. John! Hey, how you doing? Great, great. Hey, did you get a chance to go over those final comps that I sent over? Well, super, yeah. It sounds like we're almost there. No, I know, it's been a long 4 months, yeah. I'm sorry, John. Could you repeat that for me, please?
Ray.
John, can you hang on a second?
Sorry to interrupt, but he wants to see you upstairs.
John, something's come up. Can I call you right back?
All right, thanks a lot.
Well, he must be hiding something.
Mother.
Well, have you met his parents?
Didn't I already talk to you about this?
Talk to me about what?
Matt, could you? Thanks.
So, talk to me about what?
I could have sworn I already talked to you about this. His parents died in a car accident when he was a kid.
I'm sorry.
No, there's nothing to be sorry about. It happened a long time ago. He barely remembers, I think.
So who raised him?
He grew up in an orphanage.
An orphanage? There weren't relatives? There wasn't somebody who could take him?
I don't know, Mother. You know, he doesn't really like to talk about it. It was pretty hard on him, you know? It'd be hard on anybody growing up like that.
Well, I imagine so, sweetie. No, I'm sorry. I had no idea. I guess we should be grateful that we still have each other.
Well, is it possible to reschedule for this Tuesday at 3 o'clock? No, I'm sorry. He's booked up that entire day. Well, I understand, but... Well, would you like to schedule for Thursday the 20th? He has an opening at 11:30.
Oh, no, I'm sorry. That's the problem. You wanted to see me, Jack?
Raymond, come on in. Have a seat. I've been watching these old home movies. This one here, it's nearly 30 years old. We've taken the kids on a camping trip. They've all grown up, have their own families now. goes by so fast. You find yourself catching up to it rather than living it.
So, how's the Mercer account coming?
Great. Great. In fact, I was just on the phone with John Phillips when you called, and he's very excited about what we've done so far. He just has a few minor changes to make, and then we're finished with production. In fact, I'm glad that you called me up here, Jack. I wanted to go over some of the expected projections with you for the next couple of months. Thanks. I sat down earlier and did a quick market analysis based on the feedback that we've received so far. Most of this should be pretty accurate. Now, after 1 week of airtime, we should be seeing a market share increase somewhere between 7 and 8 points. Now, after the first month, this is when things really...
Well, that all looks fine. Well, why don't you send up a copy to me tomorrow? I'll take a look at it then.
Okay, sure. I'll do that.
Raymond, the reason I wanted to see you, well, I'll get straight to the point. In the short time that you've been with us, you've managed to bring in Tracorp, Anderson, and just recently, the Mercer account. I don't believe I have to tell you what an impact that has made. We'd like you to take over Tom Bradley's position as our new executive creative director. What do you think? Think you can handle it?
Yes, you can say that. I told you, I can tell you it's a surprise.
Listen, Janice, you just get ready because you and I are going out to celebrate.
Sounds good.
Sure.
I don't know, whatever you want to do. I can't even think right now. It's been... Yeah, there's so much going on right now, and I'll tell you all about it when I get there.
Advertising.
I'm gonna explode. Do I look fatter to you? I feel fat.
No. I know you're not gonna have time now with this new position.
Time for what?
Well, time to take me out to dinner every night.
Oh, yeah.
Buy me all those presents.
Yes. I need to buy you more presents.
It's time for some new stuff, you know.
What about me? Where are my presents?
What do you want?
This?
What a waste. You see what happens when I try and take you out?
Hey. Oh,
this is the last time. I will never take you to a restaurant like this again. You understand?
Sorry, Larry. I didn't mean to bring it up.
Well, it's a little too late for that, isn't it? You already brought it up.
Please, Larry. No.
You couldn't keep that fucking mouth of yours shut through one lousy...
Did you not understand me the first time? I thought I already told you how I wanted this done.
I'm sorry, I thought that you...
There are no excuses in this house.
I'm gonna fucking learn to keep your mouth shut.
How many times are we gonna have to do this before you learn how to do it right?
I didn't mean to.
This is your fault.
Responsibility. No. You're gonna need some time to think about that.
Janice, you all right?
I'm okay. I'm not hurt.
Oh my God! Somebody help! Get an ambulance! Mary! Mary! Oh my God! Somebody help me! Mary! Somebody help me!
That's it. Maybe I am finished. It's the beginning. To the beginning.
James.
Captain. Thanks for the reminders. It was awfully sweet of you.
Been a while, hadn't it?
Yeah, I suppose it has.
Just hang in there, James. Give it a little time and things will be back like they were.
Sorry to interrupt. Can we talk about this
Could you give me 5 minutes, please?
Okay.
You got something for me?
Caucasian male, unID'd. Assaulted another Caucasian male in the parking lot of Mi Piace's over on Montford last night.
Maybe a bar fight to carry it out into the parking lot.
Only witness was the victim's wife. You'll have to talk with her.
Captain.
Thank you.
you can add begonias. You like begonias?
Begonias.
Red flowers, pink flowers.
Yes.
Okay, well, you can plant...
Janice, you have a call.
I'm sorry. Hang on 1 second. Hi, this is Janice. Hi. 1 second. You know what? I need to take this. I tell you what. The Asian jasmine and the begonias are both in the same place. You're going to follow this pathway right down there to the right. Take a look at them, and I'll be over there in just a second. That'd be okay?
Thank you.
Yes. Sure, no problem. Okay. Yeah, I can talk. You scared the hell out of me. I've never seen you act like that before.
I don't act like that, Jenna. Okay, that's not me. I'm sorry.
We just left that guy. What do you think happened to him? Do you think he's in the hospital?
I don't know. I guess he might be. I'm just still trying to figure out what happened.
Well, I saw what happened, Ray. You know, you just kept hitting him. And you wouldn't stop.
I think you hurt him pretty bad.
Ray, shouldn't we do something? Shouldn't we call the police?
No. No, I... Look, would you please just give me a chance to explain?
All right.
I'll be home by 7.
Okay.
Riverside, can you hold? Riverside, can I help you?
Yes. I'm Detective Massey, Addison Police Department. Checking on Larry Winters, brought in last night, assault victim.
Let me see. Yeah, Larry Winters checked in at 8:45 last night and checked out at 10:30 this morning.
The doctor treated him there?
Yeah. Yeah, he might be. Let me page him.
That'd be good.
Look, I know. I was there. I know what it's done to you. But Christ, James, one fucking case, man. It happened 20 years ago. You're not being suspended. It's called a medical leave.
Hello?
Go and you get some help.
Hello?
Is anybody there?
Yes, doctor. I this is Detective Massey, Addison Police Department. Larry Winters, assault victim, brought in last night.
Yes, I did, Detective. Apparently he was in some sort of fight. The way he looked, he didn't do so well.
Well,
he stayed overnight and he checked out this morning.
So it wasn't that serious?
No, I didn't say that.
Well, what are you saying?
Sometimes people don't do what's best for them.
Doctor, do you have a medical opinion on this victim?
He looked like he'd been beaten with a baseball bat. Nose broken. Or should I say flattened, a couple missing teeth.
Had he been beaten with a baseball bat?
I couldn't say. Like I said, he left before we could ask him. And we only do forensics after they're dead. He will definitely need some cosmetics done.
That bad, huh?
Yeah, that bad.
damn stupid busy work.
May I help you?
Ms. Winters?
I'm
Detective Massey. Investigating the assault you reported last night. Mind if I sit?
Oh, no, of course.
So, let's hear your side of the story.
Well, it's all the same as I told that cop, the policeman last night.
Fine. Then you won't mind repeating it for me.
Well, we were just coming out of the restaurant, just walking to our truck, and this crazy jumps on Larry out of nowhere and starts hitting him.
So, what the guy who attacked your husband look like?
I didn't see him so good. It all happened so quick. But he was dressed real nice. I think he was wearing a suit.
So what the girl look like?
She had brownish red hair, about normal size. She was wearing a black dress.
Is that all you can recall?
Oh. When she ran over to try to stop him, she said, "Stop Ray." Ray. So his name is Ray. I didn't remember that last time.
So what happened next?
They just took off. The two of them just peeled out of the parking lot. After what had happened, I couldn't believe it. The nerve.
Yeah. The nerve. Did you happen to see what kind of car they were driving?
No, not really. Might have been some sort of truck, I don't know.
Did you get a license number? And your husband, Mr. Winters, didn't do anything to provoke this attack?
No. We were just walking to our truck.
Come in.
Ray, I'm going to lunch now, so I'll be back in a little while.
Okay, thanks, Helen. This is Ray.
Hello, Ray.
Who is this?
You don't remember me no more, son. You better. Because your time is wearing itself down close to nothing.
Look, I don't know who you are, but I'm very busy and I know
that little girl of yours last night. She was all shook up.
Ray, I'm back from lunch. Ray. Ray. Are you okay?
Yeah, well, I told the cops everything when they were here. Maybe one of the waitresses would remember.
So you never saw the perpetrator?
What?
The man who beat the guy up.
Listen, like I told the cops last night, there was a lot of screaming coming from the parking lot outside, so I went outside to see what was going on, and when I saw what had happened, I came back inside, and I called 911. And that's really all I know.
Do you suppose I could see the credit card receipts from last night, say between 7:30 and 9 o'clock?
Love to.
Charges have been dropped.
What? Why? This guy was beat up pretty good.
It doesn't matter. It's done. Just do the paper and close it.
Thank you.
last night had a lot to do with my father.
Your father?
This is a lot harder than I thought it would be. I don't remember everything, but I remember that there were nights that he would come home late after work and he would start to drink. He'd get real mean. I don't ever remember what it was about, but, she'd always say something that would get to him. And when that happened, things turned ugly. And he'd start to hit her. You know, I'd always remember that he would hit her in the exact same spot. You know, maybe one night it was the chest, or the other night it was the shoulder, or the other night it was the face. Jesus Christ. I was 5 years old. I mean, is this real? I mean, can I be having these memories when I was that young?
Honey. Maybe it's just one of those things, you know, or the more traumatic the experience, the more
you know, it's like he knew that he wasn't going to be around for very long, so he just pounded it into me just right. And my mother, that it's like she was just waiting to die. And all I can remember was her crying, and there's nothing that I could do. I was helpless. Jesus Christ, I'm so scared of him.
It's okay. There's nothing you could do.
And I don't know. I guess in the parking lot last night, I don't know where I was or what I was doing, and I just completely lost it.
It's okay. It's okay. I understand.
I was at the couch, and
wish. It's okay. You don't have to tell me anymore.
Nothing means more to me than this family's well-being.
Some people get the idea they can do whatever they want. All they think about is themselves. Somewhere along the line, they started taking advantage.
What the hell are you doing, you stupid son of a bitch?
Now they just keep on taking. You wait right here, son.
There's a wrong way to do things, and there's a right way. If you and your mother haven't learned that by now, you will. Pretty girl you got there.
Thank you for telling me what you did last night. It means a lot to me that you were able to tell me that.
I wanted to tell you a lot sooner. It's just... I don't know. Go your whole life keeping something like that to yourself, and it becomes a habit, I guess. Before now, I just never wanted to tell anybody else.
Do you think the stuff that happened with your dad, do you think that has anything to do with your nightmares?
You know what? That stuff that happened to me happened a long time ago, okay? And I told you what I did last night so that we could get on with us, okay? That part of me is over.
Over? You know, I mean, after what you did the other night.
What happened the other night was just a reaction, and that is it, okay? It's not gonna happen. It's not gonna happen again.
For sure. I think there might be more to this, though, than you
No, Janice, there's not. There's not.
Okay. Okay. Have you thought about talking to someone? I mean, just to see if they can...
What, a psychiatrist? Is that what you're talking about, a psychiatrist? Jesus, Janice, you gotta be fucking kidding me.
Okay. No, not a psychiatrist. I don't know. What about a support group?
Janice, listen. My problems are just that, okay? They are my problems. I've always dealt with them myself, and I always will deal with them myself, and I'm certainly not gonna see a fucking psychiatrist about it.
Ray. We don't always have an easy time handling the problems in our lives. Sometimes talking helps.
Talking helps, huh?
Yeah.
Well, guess what? We're talking now, and it's not doing me a hell of a lot of good.
Calm down. Honey, you're taking this the wrong way. That is not what I'm saying. There's nothing wrong with talking to someone.
There's nothing wrong with me.
That is not what I'm saying. Why are you being so defensive?
Why are you pushing me like this?
Well, I am not pushing you.
No, yeah,
I'm
you
just
are
trying
pushing
to help
me.
You
Janice, you're pushing me. You're going on and on about this, and you won't fucking shut up, all right? And maybe I'm not the one with the problem here. Maybe you're the one with the problem. Maybe you should get some fucking help.
I'm sorry.
You need help. And if you're not willing to get it, I can't do this.
I'm just going through some... I'm gonna work this out.
I don't know if I can believe that.
You've got to believe that. You've got to trust me, okay?
I need some time. Time to think about all this.
What are you talking about, time?
I'm gonna go stay with my mother.
You don't have to do that. I just need a little bit more.
Just for a couple of days.
No, that's me, Kathy. Not right now. I'm going.
Yeah, give me that. Okay?
Hello? Anybody home? by the nursery to
see if he'd stop by there.
You got about 10 seconds to unpack this shit. One. Two. Three.
Who did this, son? Who did this? Did your daddy do this? Did you do this?
Oh. Jesus, my head.
Wake up. Come on, Janice, wake up. Wake up! If you don't leave him, Don, I swear to God I'm gonna kill him.
No, James.
I've got to do something about it. I can't let him keep on doing this to you. God damn it.
I'm sorry. Please don't cry.
I'm scared. I'm so scared of him.
It's okay. You don't have to be scared of him anymore. You've got me now, and I am going to take care of you. I promise you that. Okay?
Can I help you?
Raymond Ryan?
Yeah.
I'm Detective Massey, Addison Police Department. You were at the Mi Piace's restaurant Thursday night?
We were having dinner there. Is there a problem?
A man was assaulted in the parking lot. Outside the restaurant. I thought maybe you might have seen something.
No, we just, we had dinner and then we drove straight home.
Who were you with Thursday night? At the restaurant?
My girlfriend. My girlfriend was with me.
Her name?
What's this all about, Detective? I told you that we had dinner. We didn't see anything.
It's just procedure, sir. She was at the restaurant. It's quite possible that she saw something that might help my investigation.
And I'm telling you that she didn't.
Mr. Ryan, are we going to have a problem here? Are you going to let me do my job? What's your girlfriend's name?
Janice March.
You can remember anything more about the other night? Call me at this number. I appreciate your cooperation, Mr. Ryan.
It's all right today.
got your eyes. You blame me? You're right. I should have stopped it. I knew enough. I knew all I needed to know. I'm tired, Donna.
Dennis? Yeah, not interested, thanks.
I was wrong to keep it from you. I know better than that. Keeping things from you is like lying to you.
What else?
When my son gets punished, what I did, it's my fault. I'm the one responsible.
You owe our son an apology.
Come home. what happened there?
No.
Nothing? Donna, this is the last time. I'm taking him in.
I can't. If he finds out about us, I don't know what he's going to do.
Listen to me. He is never going to stop. I know this. But you and the boy have got to get out of that house. Promise me, Donna.
Sir, I'm sorry, but we're closed. Sir?
Janice March?
Yes?
Detective Massey, Addison Police Department.
Oh. Sir, I'm sorry. Could you not smoke in here? Plants?
I need to talk to you, Ms. Martin. I'm working on an assault case. Happened a couple of nights ago at a restaurant near here.
Oh?
During my investigation, I ran across the name Raymond Ryan. I believe you know him.
Is Ray in trouble?
I'm afraid it's not that simple. I know he did it. And yes, he might have been in trouble if the victim hadn't dropped the charges.
The charges, they've been dropped?
Yes.
So then the man, he wasn't hurt that bad?
I wouldn't say that. Ms. March, do you know why your boyfriend assaulted that man? Why don't you tell me what happened? Can't do anything. I told you the charges have been dropped. There is no case. Do you understand?
Well, then if that's true, why are you here? What's this all about?
Let's say I'm concerned. Concerned for your safety.
I don't understand what you're talking about.
Talking about Ray. I think he is potentially a very dangerous man, and I wanted to come here tonight and warn you.
Warn me? About Ray? Ray would never. You think that because of what happened the other night?
Ms. March, I sort of knew Ray when he was a child. I was a close friend of his mother, Donna. It was a long time ago. Ray's father murdered his mother. Ray's father, Will Ryan, took Donna's life.
Well, that's not true. Ray's parents died in a car wreck.
I saw it myself. Found Ray behind a chair. He was just a little kid. Thought I saw the whole thing. He was shuffled around a lot with Child Protective Services, and I never knew what happened to him. And then 2 days ago, out of the blue, this case landed on my desk.
Does Ray remember what happened?
I don't know what Ray remembers. He was in shock when we found him. I don't know. I'm sure someone told him at some point.
The dreams. I can't believe this happened.
Martin, hear me out. When I found out it was Ray that assaulted that man, I started following the two of you. And...
following us?
Please, don't be upset. I had to. Something is going on with Ray. I think he's starting to lose control. I've seen it in him. His father. I've seen the pattern before. His mother died because I didn't do anything.
This is crazy, okay?
I understand. I knew his mother. I loved his mother. And I let her die. I loved her. And I'm trying to warn her the same way I'm trying to warn you.
Look, Detective. I think that this has gotten to be a little bit too much. And I'm through. Okay, I mean, I'm Ray. Needs help dealing with this, but nothing like that is going to happen.
I don't have much drink left. I need to help you much more than this. I know what I'm talking about. There's something bad going on here. I can feel it.
I've had about as much as I can take of this, okay? Detective, I think you should... Ray, hey, it's me. When you get this message, I'm at the nursery now, but I'm headed home to Mom's. So, just give me a call there. I really need to talk to you. Bye.
It's at the nursery. Are you talking to that cop?
I don't understand. What are you doing
here?
What
did you tell him?
Tell who?
The cop.
All right.
Everything's all right, Ray. The charges in the case, they were dropped.
He told you this?
Yeah. Are you okay?
Okay. Why didn't you call me back?
I told you, I just needed to take
Don't give me that shit.
Ray. Ray, I know what happened.
Know about what?
I know about your mom. I know what happened.
You don't know shit.
Ray, you have to face this. You have to let me help.
Look out, Matt!
What? What is it, Ray? Ray, let me help you. I want to help.
Just stop!
It was your fault, Ray. What's the matter, Ray?
Tell me what's going on. Why don't you tell me?
Tell your girlfriend some more than lies, son. You're just like your mother. Goddamn liar.
Shut up.
Ray, you're starting to scare me. Stop doing this to yourself. I'm right here.
Oh, I'm here, all right. I've always been here. You should know that by now. Didn't you learn nothing I taught you?
No, it was you. Not me. It was your fault. You killed
Shut
her.
Shut up, son. You know you did wrong. And now you gotta suffer some consequences.
What are you gonna do? What consequences? I didn't do nothing.
That's right. You didn't, did you? You ran away and hid. You just sat there and let her die.
Just shut your fucking mouth!
Where's your girlfriend now?
If you touch her...
It's too late, Ray. It's already done.
You son of a bitch.
Thank you.
Yeah, just go back to bed.